Now, this is the equation at any node. I already know what the values of the values of y are at node 1, which is 0, and I only know the value of the node at, of y at node 4, which is 0. So all I need to do is I need to write down this equation for I equal to 2 and I equal to 3. So when I write down the equation for I equal to 2, I get y sub 3 minus 2 y sub 2 plus y sub 1 divided by delta x squared. Delta x is 25. Minus 2 times 10 to the power minus 6, and this is a node 2 I'm writing the equation. So I is 2 there, is equal to 75 times 10 to the power minus 6. The value of node x of I, which is x of 2, is 25. Because that's the value of node at x2 times 75 minus 25. Because that's the value of the node x2. So it's very important to understand what needs to be substituted and how we are substituting these for a particular node. So same thing I'm going to use for I equal to 3. I'm going to write down the same equation for I equal to 3. So this general equation which I have here, I'm going to write for I equal to 3, which means that I substitute node I equal to 3 there. I get y sub 4 minus 2 y sub 4 plus y sub y sub 3 plus y sub 2 divided by 25 squared minus 2 times 10 to the power minus 6 times the value of y at that particular node, which is y sub 3, equal to 75 times 10 to the power minus 6. This is the right hand side. And I have to substitute the value of x of I. The x of I at node 3 is 50 times 75 minus 50. So I have to be careful about what I substitute for the proper values of x and so on and so forth. So I have basically first equation, last equation, second equation, third equation. So I write down the equation. So this will be the equation for the first node, the equation for the second node, the equation for the third node, and the equation for the fourth node. And that's how I'm going to write down my equations. So when I write down these equations in the matrix form, this is what I get for my coefficient matrix. So I have four unknowns, y sub 1, y sub 2, y sub 3, y sub 4. And then I'll have certain right-hand sides. I only know that the first equation is y sub 1 equal to 0, so I get 1, 0, 0, 0. And of course it is 0 at that particular point. And the last equation will be the equation for the last node. Again, y sub 4 is equal to 0. So the other two equations which I will get by making the calculations, I get 0.0016 minus 0.003202, 0.0016, and then 0. Then here I get 0.0016 minus 0.003202, and 0.0016. So that's what I get as my four equations, four unknowns. The right-hand side here is 0.9375 and 0.9375 here. So I have four equations, four unknowns. Again, you got to realize that you have four equations, four unknowns. This is a tri-diagonal system of equations, and also this is a diagonally dominant system of equations. So you do need to figure out what does that help us. The tri-diagonal system of equations will help us to directly use Thomas's algorithm to be able to solve this set of equations. Since this particular matrix is diagonally, the coefficient matrix is diagonally dominant, that's also going to help us to be able to use iterative methods and be guaranteed a solution. So the solution turns out to be y sub 1, y sub 2, y sub 3, and y sub 4 is equal to, of course, we know that the first one will be 0, last one will be 0, because those are the boundary conditions. And this turns out to be minus 0.5852 and minus 0.5852. So those are deflections which you get at node 2 and node 3. You can solve this particular differential equation exactly. The value at y at 25, because that's the value at y sub 2, let's suppose, is y sub 25. So y of 25 is same as y2. Y2 is same as y sub 25 is exactly equal to minus 0.5365. So I want to leave this as homework, that use your ordinary differential equation knowledge, which you have learned, and be able to find out what the exact solution to this particular problem is. So it turns out that the value of y25 turns out to be minus 0.5365. And the corresponding true error to that will be 9.07%. So it will be up to you to now maybe break the segments between 0 and 75 into more segments and see that whether you are able to get closer to the exact value of, let's suppose, y25 and other points which are there. Because once you find the exact solution, you'll be able to find the value of y at any point you're interested in. But specifically for this case, are you able to reduce the amount of true error by choosing more segments for the length of 75 inches? And that's the end of this segment.